Okay, thought I would get a little video today. I'm at the Rock Hawk, one of the Rock Hawk trails. This is the blue trail for the Rock Hawk area. There's at the trailhead parked. It's only a 2.8 mile walk. Already got a morning walk in this morning and decided that I really wanted to get out in the woods a little bit, so this is what we're doing. This loop here, it's called the Blue Loop. Like I said, it's 2.8 miles. There's a little shortcut there. You can get a little bridge across. One of the other nice things about this particular trail, it is self-interpretive. There are many of these signs that I've passed already. I didn't want to film because these guys they're practicing their bow hunting, and I didn't want to bother them. But yeah, it isn't just that. It's a true self-interpretive nature hike on this plant trail. It looks like we've made it to the... It's a bear! And nobody messing with the bear too much. This is about as close you want to get to one. So, yeah, I'm going to get to the fake bear. And how about that? So this is an old quarry. And you will remember, if you watch some of my previous videos, a trip that I made to Little's Cemetery. The big rocks that I noted about Little's Cemetery were quarried from this quarry. And one of the things they say about this quarry, which you have to watch out for, is snakes, because they like the sun on the rocks. But I picked a good day for hiking. It's only about 80 degrees, kind of overcast. It's been in the 90s the other days. But yeah, they quarried the rocks for the Little Cemetery and some of the other buildings for some of the big plantation owners and what have you. Somebody left an arrow. Must be shot. We got a little trail going up the top of the quarry. I might just take this for a minute. But yeah, that's where these, you know, they had a bunch of stone taken out of here to do all that sort of thing. There's a bunch of exposed granite in this area. And somebody's walked up here. So here we are, top of the quarry. You can see the big exposed granite area, lichen growing up on the rock. But yeah, like I said, I wanted to get out of the woods. I don't know, it's something that for me is, I don't know if I need it. I mentioned it before, but it's good for me to get out and do this sort of thing. This exposed area, there's a really, really, really massive exposed granite area also in this park. And I don't know if it's the same belt that runs like up to Stone Mountain, Georgia or not, but it's the same thing if you go to Panola Mountain, which is a lot closer to Stone Mountain than this one. Somebody's done a little circle of rocks thing going on here. What that's all about, but I don't know, you got a lot of these in Georgia, and I don't know, I suppose they had some sort of significance. Somebody's trying to erect their own version of Stonehenge here, I think. No comparison, really. I've never been seeing it, but somebody's doing some earth stuff. Whatever going on here, playing with the rocks. You gotta watch out for rattlesnakes, that sort of thing, messing around places like this. That's your biggest danger. So just out enjoying the day. It's the 14th of September. And I don't know, it's only about 20, not even 20 feet, I don't think, off of that ground down there. But there's a lot of rock that was quarried out of here. And I'm going to go back the way I came, because this looks, you know, like more than I care to walk through today. So I'm going to go take this little trail back. And I'll hit you with some other cool stuff if I find any. All right, so I'm down from the upper part of the quarry. I'm down in the lower. Obviously, they never quarried this. They built a wall of rocks, I guess, to keep people from stumbling over there. Okay. Got some yuccas, which the roots of the yucca plant are edible. Potato, you can cook them. I've heard of people taking those yucca tips, and you see how they got that curly fiber. They say you can fiber out the strand of a yucca and use it as an emergency sewing kit with a built-in needle on the tip. So I've never had to try that, but just for those of you who, if you're in a pinch one day and you're around some yuccas, you may need to use that for something. You can let me know how it worked out for you. I'll stick with needle and thread as long as I have that available, I think. So this is the lower side of the quarry. Moving on. Got a little cactus growing on the side of the trail here. Okay, next point, I'm down the big hill, which is really just a rise, I would call it. This was an actual creek flowing last I was here, because it's end of summer, and if you were counting on this as a water source, you'd be in trouble. Okay, I'm making it up on the, I'll call it the alternate parking area. I don't know if the gate is always open to this or not, but I want to say it's close to the halfway point on this trail, maybe a little before. Something like that. You'll see. They've cut the grass since I was here last. The trail is kept up well. I've just kicked a few sticks and rocks out. There were four mountain bikers that passed me. You can see there's another trailhead. The main highway that goes into Rock Hawk is right down off of that road. So it's really interesting to see how things have changed. This is the waterfowl viewing area. When I was here, it was just, 6 months ago or so. Everywhere you see this grass was water. And wow, obviously it's very shallow water. It's just a wetland area, I guess. This is incredible to see how different this is now. So, very shallow. Butterflies. Since the butterflies on that video where I saw the day that my son had died and I didn't know, I never see a butterfly and not think about him now. So that's the way it is for me now. I can't see one of those things without thinking about him now, because of that, what happened that day. So yeah, this was this was a dock, and this dock was over water. This whole thing was a peninsula, like a swampy area. There was water all in there. The frogs were loving it. And I had video of all the frogs singing. And yeah, you can see this, obviously, this is a dock. Well, it went out over the water. There was water all the way up to the base of the thing. So obviously we're in the dry season. So yeah, see, it was water all the way up in here. All this was water. And I remember stepping over to get onto the dock. And the dock isn't, this one isn't very well maintained at the end here, but the boards are very sturdy still to walk on. But I don't know whether this was a shelter. It looks like they gave up this one for the new one that they built. But yeah, this is all overlooking water. Obviously, I could have waded through it, but I wouldn't have wanted to because it was cool then. Cooler weather. So we'll go over and get in the tower over there. I'll have a snack. Okay, it's pretty nice up here. See that? And nice benches to sit on. And we're overlooking this, which I said was wetland earlier in the year. And this was all swamp. There's water all in this, behind it too. This is like a peninsula out of all the water all around it. And I'm sure when the wet season comes, it'll be back. Wrapping up this trail, it looks like. And I met someone named Holly. It's a Hollywood tree. There's an old story behind that. You can research that for yourself. The name Hollywood in California. All that mess behind that. And moving on up the trail, there was a whole bunch of benches just down around the corner up the hill there. I didn't know, it looked like you had a place for a lecture or something out in the woods. It was interesting, and it looks like nobody had sat on them in years. And this fence is kind of falling down, but overall, the trail's in good shape. I've done a little maintaining, like that. Along the way, kicking rocks and sticks out of the way, making it a little better for the next people to come by. Might as well. I'm not in a hurry, and I don't know, that's kind of the way I pay back my enjoyment of an area. Picked up a little couple small things of trash, nothing bad on this trail. It's nice. The leaves are falling. This is another bridge. The other one back that way somewhere. Some more exposed rock there. See, you can see it through there. Only 4x magnification on this one. Okay, you have to be careful with that magnification, moving the lens around, moving the phone. So, big rock. There's a little more history on the Little family. Like they had a ferry. That's from 1947, that picture. Look at that. That's a couple of mules and a wagon. Little family home site. Like I said, the cemetery's back across the main road. I already did a video of that. And slowly scan this and I'll read it later myself. Site. That's the chimney, which you see, and this is something from the 40s. And then they've got this area fenced off, and I'm guessing that's where the home site was, and they don't want anybody doing any digging. I don't know. Interesting. Well, I guess you can go in there. The fence is wide open. Oh, that's another. That's a cemetery in there. I see a gravestone. That's the one I went to. Okay, this is the slave cemetery. That's where I'm at now. Let's go over in here, take a look at it. Nobody's keeping this up anymore. I don't know, this whole area is fenced off. I guess they decided to leave it open because people were coming in here anyway. I don't know if this whole thing was a cemetery that I'm walking on. I'm gonna guess that it was, because I am in a fenced area. And there hasn't been much maintaining done. There's a headstone here. The ground sunk in beneath it. Wow. On both sides of it, actually. George S. Daniel, private U.S. Army. That's not a slave grave there. April 16th, 1941. And look, we've got a sunk-in area here. Sunk-in area here. Sunk-in area here. So I'm going to guess three graves right there. One, two, three. And there's going to be another one right here. There, ground's all sunk in. Oh, wow. Look at this. It just keeps going. Just out of the way. There's another one there. And you can see that a rock was placed as a headstone, just a rock. And then, so this is a grave here. There's another one right there. Wow, this whole thing is a graveyard. I don't want to. That's nothing. Just a rock to mark it. That's it. There's nothing etched on the rock. Just a rock to let you know, hey, this was a grave. Here's another one. Just a rock. Another one. Just a rock. And that's why this area is fenced off. And obviously trees have knocked part of the fencing in. And nobody's maintaining this, but several old graves. And I'm just, it's obvious by all the depressions in the area. Several bodies here. Okay, finished up the Blue Loop Trail. Did a little piece of the Yellow Trail. Visited the, there's another cemetery on that trail. I'll probably show that in another video. But this is a bridge. 360. On the bridge, headed back to the car. Enjoyable day. Good way to, I don't know, get the blood flowing, de-stress, relax, spend some time in the woods, make it back to the car, which is there. Place where he left the water. And I didn't look at these maps. Well, these are the good maps. I'm gonna grab one of these. Anyway, that's it. There's the element. I'm gonna grab one of these and head home, see if there's any in here. Ah, yes, there are. The maps at the Rock Hawk are not the ones I wanted. They're just a map of the camping area. So I'm gonna grab that. I'm gonna go home. Cook me and my mom something for dinner, and do some video editing. Thanks for coming along, Atypical Hiker. See you in the next video.